Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil anbiya'i wal mursalin. Nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu ala man ittaba'al huda. All praises be to Allah, and may Allah's peace and blessings be upon His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his family, companions, and all those who followed them in righteousness until the last day. May Allah's peace be upon those who are following guidance. Respected and beloved brothers and sisters in faith and in humanity, good afternoon to you all. We are gathered today for a very important and historic show of unity between peace-loving people in spite of their differences in culture, political stance, or creed. Welcome to our symposium on peace and unity, entitled as Islam, Religion of Peace and Mercy. A topic which is both timely and important, especially on these days when the dream of peace and unity in Mindanao is being overshadowed by the warmongering politicians who are calling for an all-out war against our Filipino brothers here in Mindanao. The dream of unity, which is also overshadowed by the cries of war which are being belched out by the people who may have been fueled by emotions or simply by the benefit of war profiteering. Because as far as we know, ever since the dawn of civilizations, war is always costly, war is always expensive, and it always gives the most benefit to those who are in power. But this is never the way that Muslims think of things. We are not like the warring, lawless people the mainstream media like to portray. The Muslims give precedence to the sanctity of the human life more than anything else in this world. The human life of the Muslim or a non-Muslim is more important than his own life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, وَتَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders the people that we should cooperate with each other in righteousness and piety and not to cooperate in sin and disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. With this, the Muslims know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders us to be good with the rest of humanity, whether they are Muslims like us or they are people from other religions. There is no such thing as hatred which is brought about by being a non-Muslim, or Muslims hating other people because they are non-Muslims. These things being called like holy war or Islamism or fundamentalism are terminologies which were invented by those who are in power in order to demonize and dehumanize the Muslims who are originally peace-loving people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by saying this in the Quran, and this order is originally in the context to be followed by the Muslims, but this is also true with the rest of humanity. Thus, we are today united in our cause to show our support for peace and not for war. But before this, let us go back in time to a time when the anti-Muslim sentiment began. Actually, the anti-Muslim sentiment that is rampant in today's media is inherited. It did not just come today. Looking back in time, during the Middle Ages, we know of the Crusades that were being launched from Europe against the Muslims who are in Jerusalem. the territory which is currently occupied by Israel, but the Muslims prefer to call it as Palestine because this is the original name of the domain being lived in or populated by the Muslims there. This anti-Muslim sentiment continues with the so-called Reconquista, the reconquest of the Christians of the Iberian Peninsula, also known as Spain and Portugal today. We have known that about 1,000 years ago, Muslims has conquered this vast area. But during the Middle Ages, the Christians were able to invade Spain again, and they were able to drive away the Muslims from there, whom they call as the Moors. The Spanish people, as we know them now, or the Castilas, they drove away the Moors, who were originally from Morocco, from North Africa. And when they arrived here in the Philippines in 1521, and from there, when the Spaniards came and discovered that there are Muslims here in the Philippines, especially in Manila, which was ruled by Raja Sulaiman by that time, and Raja Lacandula of Tondo, and here in Mindanao, and there in Mactan by Lapu-Lapu, they called the Muslims here as Moros, the same way they addressed the Muslims of Spain. And from there, the hatred of the Spaniards was transferred, was taught to the schools, and is being proliferated by the educational system that was developed by the priests who established the schools and universities in the Philippines. So that's why we now have senators who were educated under this system who have this view against the Muslims, that they think that the only solution to the Moro problem is the total annihilation of the Moro people, which we are now united to stand against. And also, we as the people of Davao, we as the people of Davao City in particular know better. We know that whenever there is smoke, there is fire, and we do not fight fire with fire. As one of the safest cities in the world in terms of peace and security, under the leadership of our beloved city mayor, Rodi Duterte, we know better. We, the people of Davao, know better. We know that peace and security is never born out of tyranny. It is born out of being friends with the people and being just in dealing with them. Mercy Islamic Center of Davao City shares this belief. Aside from our function of delivering the message of salvation through the worship of one true God, Allah, as Ustadh Idris Dakyo has explained earlier, we share the vision of the people of Davao City of a peaceful and prosperous Mindanao. A testament to the mission of the Mercy Islamic Center to stand for the meaning of Islam, which literally came from the word aslama, which means to surrender and submit, and to the word salam, meaning peace. The name Islam being chosen for this religion is not merely a nominal name, or is not called for name-calling purposes only. Islam is a name chosen by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, "Inna ad-dina indallahi al-Islam." Indeed, the religion for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Islam. Islam is submission to the will of Almighty God, Allah, who sent the prophets like Noah, Abraham, Moses, Jesus, and Prophet Muhammad, salawatullahi wa salamuhu alayhim. A Muslim is someone who submits and surrenders himself to Allah. Islam is also peace. A Muslim is someone who is at peace with his Creator by being obedient to him, and through which the Muslim is at peace with himself and others. Mercy Center officially opened last December 13, 2014 or December 13, 2013 and has since been an active part of the Davao City civic and religious community. Since its inception, we aimed at propagating the real message of Islam, which is that of worship of the one true God, and that of peace and mercy to mankind. We are educating not only the Muslims, but also the non-Muslims as well about the message of Islam, and we are continuing this vision to educate the Muslims especially so that they will not be victims to radicalism and other false idealisms which are being spread in the Muslim masses in the guise of Islam when they are not. We have had programs in different private and government institutions such as residences, government offices, hospitals, universities, and others in order to cater to a wider sector of people, including the program we're having today. As such a vision is always fresh in our hearts because our president and founder, Sheikh Muhammad Al-Khulaki, is constantly reminding us that being good with our fellow humans is also a form of showing godliness. That's why Mercy Islamic Center is also an active part of many of the relief efforts being held here in Davao City, and the most notable of such was the relief effort that we have made for the victims of the fire at Isla Verde last year. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also mentioned a very important verse which was actually read at the beginning of this program. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, and I want to mention and give emphasis on this particular verse again. He said, لا ينهاكم الله عن الذين لم يقاتلوكم في الدين ولم يخرجوكم من دياركم أن تبروهم وتقسطوا إليهم إن الله يحب المقسطين. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah does not forbid you from those who do not fight you in religion and do not fight you or do not drive you out of your homes, that you deal kindly and deal justly with them. Indeed, Allah loves those who act justly. So this particular verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned that He is not forbidding the Muslims on having good relationships with non-Muslims. We are not being forbidden by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to invite soldiers, to invite policemen, to invite all the other people, whether they're Muslims or not Muslim, not or non-Muslims, if they are not from those who fight us in our religion. Meaning, if they are not amongst those who are oppressing us. And here in Davao City, alhamdulillah, we as Muslims are not being oppressed in any way. Alhamdulillah, we have a very loving mayor who is very accommodating, and he is very cooperative with the Muslims even in our festivities. But again, Islam is not a religion of meekness. I do not want this statement of mine to be misunderstood or to be taken as in any other context other than what is really meant by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Islam is not a religion of meekness, but Islam, or rather Islam, is a religion of reason. We do not feign. Muslims do not pretend to be peaceful in the face of oppression. Muslims do not pretend not to do anything when they are being oppressed or being stepped upon. So that is why it is clear for a Muslim when and how to act in order to defend himself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in continuation to the previous verse I've mentioned and I've read, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا يَنْهَاكُمُ اللَّهُ أَنِ الَّذِينَ قَاتَلُوكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ وَأَخْرَجُوكُمْ مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ وَظَاهَرُوا عَلَىٰ إِخْرَاجِكُمْ أَنْ تَوَلُّوهُمْ وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّهُمْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the first verse He is not forbidding us to deal justly with those who do not oppress us. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to defend ourselves and allows us to stand up for our rights against those who step upon us, who oppress us, and drive us out of our homes. Whether it's in Maguindanao, Zamboanga, Jolo, Tawi-Tawi, Cotabato, or anywhere else. But this act of defending one's homeland is not supposed to be an act of barbarism. There are laws, there are regulations that the Muslims must follow. Peace and mercy has been the beginning and the end of the message of Islam. Actually, even on times of war, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has laid down many rules on how to deal with combatants and non-combatants. And it has been shown by the Muslims, in many different occasions. And we will find about that, especially if we are going to look at some of the most important events during the lifetime of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the last prophet. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam began propagating Islam, it was through peaceful conversations with the people. But the people who were against him and the people who are against the message of Islam and the worship of only one true God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has been met with extreme prejudice until there are times that the early Muslims are being tortured, jailed, or being killed. Until the time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordered the Muslims to emigrate to a different land in order to peacefully observe their religion. But the hatred of their enemies escalated and even wars were waged against the Muslims. But they defended themselves and triumphed against the invaders. But in spite of the hostilities, Islam showed that it's all about peace and mercy. When Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam ordered the victors, the Muslim victors of each battle where they are victorious, to be just upon the captive enemies and the other rules of engagement be strictly enforced. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has forbidden the mutilation of the dead enemy, of the body of the dead enemy. That's why it is clear for the Muslims how to conduct himself even on times of war. And these rules of engagement and the proper treatment of combatants and non-combatants during time of war has been enforced long before there was the Magna Carta or the Bill of Rights or the Geneva Convention or the standardization of the fair treatment of prisoners of war and non-combatants in a war zone. Islam has already shown its version of the human rights 1,500 years ago, before any of the human rights has been written down by the human civilization. And finally, when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam succeeded in defeating his enemies who drew the first blood in the first place during the conquest of Mecca, his own homeland, he showed clemency and given them amnesty instead of executing them all as their political enemies or as an act of revenge. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in spite of exacting revenge against his enemies, he ordered these people, idhabu fa antum at-tulaqa, go because you are free. Such is the peace and mercy that was exhibited by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet of Islam, the Prophet who is being emulated by the Muslims. Yes, as what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. that you will find the best example upon the Prophet of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in conclusion of my message, we all want peace. But peace is something that everyone should want. Let us ask the guidance of the Almighty Creator, the one and only true God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and let us pray that this gathering of ours be fruitful, inshallah. And let me remind you again of one important verse in the Quran regarding the message of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. We did not send you forth, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except as mercy to mankind. So thank you very much. And to all our brothers and sisters in faith, wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.